Hey everyone, today I want to share with you building share extensions using Swift. We're going to write a simple app that lets us select an image in our photo album and share it to our application. So, what is a share extension? A share extension is a mini app that we can associate with our main app that can run from a common share sheet. For example, when you select an image and then select the share icon, you have a choice of applications to share the image. The usual suspects are Facebook, Twitter, Message, and so on. Our goal is to make our application available here. So I said that this is really a mini app that we can associate with our main app. That means the lifecycle of the share app is a bit different for our main app. A share extension is started by the user selecting the icon for our app. The iOS will launch the share app. This has to happen very quickly or iOS is going to shut us down. We don't want to do anything time consuming here. If the user selects and posts an item, our code's going to run. The item can really be anything shareable. It can be a URL, image, text, or all the above. Once selected and processed, the app is shut down. All right, let's get started by looking at the app that we're going to build. This app allows us to select a photo from the photo album on our device. We'll also select a color to associate with the photo so that we can demonstrate selecting information outside of the defaults. The color will tell our app which page we should save the image. We then will share the image and the page with our application. We're going to ignore the text the user types in, but you can read it and process it with a variable context text. It's pretty trivial. When we launch our app, there are two buttons. One for the red page and one for the blue page. When we go to the red page, the image we selected for red will be displayed. The blue page will display the image we selected and associated with blue. Okay, let's implement this app. Our app is composed of the following parts. We have the main view controller with two buttons. Each segues to a view controller capable of displaying an image. The image view controllers are assigned a color red and a color blue, just so we can tell the difference. They look in the user defaults for an image saved to either the red or blue page. In our project, we also have a separate target for the share extension. This is the mini app I talked about earlier. For this tutorial, we're going to use Apple's out-of-the-box view controller for sharing. This view controller is a SLComposeServiceViewController class. If we want to do a custom share extension view, we just use our own view controller. However, we also lose some of the built-in functionality. Since we want the user to select where to display an image, we have a second view controller in our share extension. This is just a table view with a list of selectable choices. This could be dynamic and read from a database, but we'll just use red and blue. All right, let's go implement this app. The first part of our application, I won't go into too much detail here. There's not much to it. Two button segue. In the destination view controller code, we read the image from the user defaults using either a red key or a blue key. This is the code for the red view controller. The next thing we need to do is create our share extension. With our app loaded, we go to File, New, Target. We create a share extension and give it another project name. I usually add something like share extension at the end of the project name. This creates a project with a single view controller and storyboard.
Since our app extension is really a second application, it's in its own sandbox. We need a way to share data from this share app into our main app. Apple allows you to do this through app groups. We need to add our app and our share extension to the same app group.
We'll go to the project page and select the Capabilities tab. From there, we'll open up the App Groups section and turn it on. We'll also add an app group for these apps. It starts with groups and then usually I use the project name. We need to do this for both the app and the share app target. The app group name is the name we'd use for the user default suite name. This is how we're sharing data between the applications for this example. Now you'd still need to add each to a common app group if you're using some other way to share data, such as a common file system or core database. When apps are part of the same app group, they can share the same user defaults. Back in our share extension target, let's look at the share view controller. The view controller is a subclass of SLComposeServiceViewController. This is the default, and for most sharing tasks, it'll accomplish everything we need. It presents a controller with a text edit and a place we can display a thumbnail image. It also allows us to cancel or to post. There are three methods provided for us in the view controller. Configuration items, is content valid, and did select post.
isContentValid is where we check to make sure the input data is valid. It's called first and will disable the post button when it evaluates to false. We'll always return true because we're not doing anything with the text. We'll use another method later to force them to always pick images. Configuration items is where we can add more things for the user to select when they're sharing. In our app, they're sharing a photo, but they're also selecting which page to add the image. This is what we'll use to select between red and blue. A configuration item has a title, value, and tap handler. The title is the name of the configuration. We'll call ours color. The value is the currently selected value. When a user selects a configuration item, we'll launch another subview controller for this particular configuration item. The method to launch the color selection controller is called the tap handler. The color selection view controller is a table view with the selection items. Now there's nothing fancy in the table view controller, it just displays three selectable values. We could make this dynamic, but for this example, we'll just hard code the choices. We'll pass back their selected value through delegation. When the user presses the post button, didSelectPost is called. This is where we do something with the user input. The view controller has an extension context where we can get a list of NS extension items. This is an immutable array of data sent to our extension from a parent app. For our case, the Photos app is the parent app. The extension item will have a list of attachments all typed as NS item provider. NS item provider items are lazily loaded images, videos, URLs, and so on. Since we only want a photo, we'll loop through the attachments and look for one typed as an image. It will have the type identifier KUT type image. Once we find an image, we'll load it from load item for type identifier. This has a completion handler, where we're going to read the image from the URL and then we'll save it to the defaults. We save the actual image instead of a pointer because the Photos app is not in the same app group as our app or share extension. The share extension is saving the image somewhere where we can read it again. At this point, the app should run with two slightly minor points. The first is we can select more than one image. In fact, we can share other things our code isn't prepared to handle. The second is when we compile, we'll get a warning when we compile. It says, warning, embedded binaries NSExtensionActivationRule is true predicate. Apple wouldn't accept this in their App Store. What this error is trying to say is, hey, this extension is activated for everything and you can't do that. We need to tell iOS when to show our share extension and what can be selected. Open the info plist as a source code by right-clicking it, and you'll see where we need to change the values. We're going to change the NS extension attributes section. Replace it with this XML. This tells iOS to only allow the share extension to be activated when we select a single image. This means our extension is activated only for images and only when it's a single image. If you select two, the extension is not going to activate.
Wow, that was a big tutorial for such a simple thing. The source code for this is all on GitHub, so you'll want to take a look at it. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. New videos are out every week, so make sure you subscribe. This puts new videos in your YouTube feed. And if I did a good job, let me know. And with that, I'll see you in the next tutorial.